right across Australia, this is Sunrise on 7. Now, live from Brekkie Central, Nat and Sherbo.
It's 6 a.m. Thanks for joining us on Sunrise. Still ahead, calls for safer drinking water laws in Australia. The shocking new data about the quality standards. Dr. Ginny's here to break it all down.
But first, to our top story at 6 a.m. Thousands of people are set to travel to Bondi Junction, Westfield this morning for an official day of reflection, with the centre reopening its doors for the first time since the mass stabbing tragedy. Live to Liam Tapper, who's in Sydney. Liam, this is also a chance to honour our heroes.
Yeah, Nat, it really is. And so many people right across Sydney want to say thank you to those heroes. You can see already this sea of flowers that have been laid here in Bondi Junction. Candles have been lit. People have come here to, in solemn reflection, to pay their respects to those people who lost their lives, but also the workers who are here at Bondi Junction Westfield on the day, on last Saturday, when Joel Couchy went through and tragically took the lives of those six people. The doors at Bondi Junction Westfield, they will be open to the community for this day of reflection. All of these shops, they will remain closed today. A number of these shop assistants, they were there on the day. They actually lived the terror that happened here on the ground. But it's also a moment to reflect and thank our heroes, those first responders, Amy Scott, the police officer who took down Couchy. Also Bollard Man, Damien Giroux, who put his life in front of others to save more lives than were lost.
Tried to catch him, but he was going down the stairs. Then we saw him going down, so we followed him from the top, tried to maybe like throw the bullet to him, but we couldn't.
Like, I'm not gonna lie, I was scared, but you cannot just like stay away and not do anything.
Now, today's day of reflection, it will be from 11 a.m. to 5 p.m. Nat, it's a day that so many people who are hurting right across Sydney certainly need.
Yeah, you're right. Thank you, Liam. And police have laid their first charges over the Western Sydney riot that unfolded after a bishop was stabbed inside a church earlier this week. 51 police cars were damaged in that violence outside Christ the Good Shepherd Church in Wakeley. Hundreds of people flooding the area following the alleged attack. A 19-year-old was arrested in Doonside last night and charged with riot and affray. He's been refused bail to appear at Blacktown local court today. More people are expected to be charged. Here's Shevo.
Thanks, Nat. A Victorian wellness retreat where a woman was found dead after she allegedly drank a drink containing magic mushrooms has responded to the shocking incident. Let's go live to Tegan Dolling at the Coroner's Court in Melbourne. Tegan, they say the venue had been hired out.
Yeah, that's right, Sherva. We have some new details this morning around Rachel Dixon and the fact that she had actually attended this same retreat more than five times with no issues at all. We know that she tragically died after drinking that concoction, allegedly had magic mushrooms crushed up in it. Two others also drank the same drink but had no issues. Now, this is obviously part of a police investigation and also a coroner's investigation. And as you said, Solbarn, where this wellness retreat was being held, has very much distanced themselves to what has happened, saying that they often hire out their venue to private functions and that it was a private function on Saturday night. They say that those facilitating don't work or represent Solbarn and that no regular therapists were present. Now, we understand that Ms. Dixon, a mother of one here in Melbourne, also recently underwent a full medical check and that there was no issues that arose from that. So not only a police investigation still, Sherbo, but we're waiting for a toxicology report from the coroner that will hopefully give us some answers to what is a really deepening mystery. Her family and I think the community really want to hear exactly what has gone so terribly wrong.
Yeah, absolutely. Thanks, Tegan.
Let's get more news. Here's Eddie.
Thank you, Nat. Two people have had a very lucky escape overnight, emerging from this house fire in Brendale on Queensland's Moreton Bay with their lives. Multiple crews were on the scene with a big column of smoke seen rising from what's left of that property.
There was two occupants inside those inside the building. Upset, distraught, it's their livelihood.
Locals are warned of possible health impacts continuing this morning, told to keep their doors and windows closed and respiratory medication close at hand. An intense shake-up of immigration detention laws could be on the cards today when the High Court makes a decision on an Iranian asylum seeker. Let's go live to Rob Scott in our Canberra Bureau. Rob, explain this particular case to us. Why is it so contentious?
Yeah, there's a lot riding on this challenge for the government, Eddie. If it loses, around another 200 immigration detainees may have to be released. So this case has been brought by an Iranian man who's been given the pseudonym ASF-17. He's been fighting deportation since 2018. And he's refusing to cooperate with authorities who are trying to deport him, fearing he may be put to death in Iran due to his bisexuality. The court was told yesterday that he'd prefer to go anywhere, even Gaza, because he thinks he'd have a better chance of survival there. And he's hoping to piggyback off that landmark ruling from the High Court last year that indefinite detention is unlawful. That decision saw 152 immigration detainees, including murderers and rapists, released into the community. But lawyers for the Commonwealth argue that this case is totally different, and it's warning if the court ruled in this man's favour, it could encourage others to refuse to cooperate with authorities to secure their own freedom. The court is expected to hand down its decision around 10 o'clock this morning. Eddie.
Thank you, Rob. A fiery debate has erupted at a federal inquiry into Brisbane's planning for the already plagued 2032 Olympic Games. Some key senators claim the state government has not done any tangible work to prepare the city for the mass sporting event. State Parliament has tabled legislation for an independent authority for the Brisbane Olympics and Paralympic Games. A parliamentary committee examining Queensland's youth crime crisis has been dissolved after it failed to agree on which recommendations to take to government. The committee was formed in October last year to navigate ongoing reform to the youth justice system, as well as support for victims. Labor and LNP members came to a fiery impasse, unable to agree. After filing a motion, Leader of the House Mick de Brenny said that the Liberals had played politics with the issue. Melbourne police have slammed widespread ongoing protests, which has sucked 10,000 shifts from usual police duties. Let's go live to Sarah Jane Bell in Melbourne. Sarah Jane, this is costing taxpayers a huge amount too, being forked out for each one of these rallies.
Yeah, Eddie, that's right. It's because each of those protests require a heavy police presence. Every time we're out on the street seeing those protests, we see dozens, if not hundreds, of officers lining the streets to make sure that the community is safe, but also that the demonstrators are as well. And we now actually have the numbers on what this means for the police force. There's been 560 protests in the CBD over the past 6 months. That's actually more than 20 a week. And to deal with that, to watch over those demonstrators, it's taken 10,000 police shifts. Now, the CBD commander says that's taking vital police resources away from the suburbs, away from the regions, and away from tackling crime. He says when protesters don't engage with the force before one of their demonstrations, it means that they have to plan for the worst, which means more police resources to watch over them.
Thank you, Sarah Jane. We have some breaking news from Sydney now. Police have seized $500,000 in cash, multiple guns and prohibited drugs during a major crackdown this week. Strike Force detectives executed 6 search warrants across Liverpool, Maroubra, Eastlakes and Rhodes. They've been after a 36-year-old man since last year and they've managed to arrest him in these raids. He'll face court today, charged with 14 offences, half for drug supply and the other half for firearm supply.